Step right up, travelers, and enter the Grand Bazaar of History, where every merchant is a legend and every product has a story. Today's market is run by four icons: Genghis Khan, the undisputed master of warhorses; Joan of Arc, famed for her medieval armor replicas; Cleopatra, enchanting with her pharaoh's perfume; Leonardo da Vinci, selling ingenious, curious gadgets. Each of them trades in all four goods, and you will see later that their signature items dominate the ledger. Let's see how a pivot table can reveal the patterns hidden in this bustling marketplace. Our time-traveling merchants have been busy, but their sales log is as messy as a medieval marketplace. The quickest way to make sense of it? Recommended pivot tables. Before we start, I'll convert the dataset into an Excel table. I click anywhere inside it, press Ctrl plus T on Windows, or Command plus T on Mac, and confirm the range. This way, if we add new rows later, our pivot table can refresh automatically without having to change the data range. Now I click any cell in the table, go to Insert, Recommended Pivot Tables, and Excel scans the data, offering ready-made summaries, like revenue by salesperson or units sold by product. Think of it as an emperor laying out a selection of battle plans. You simply choose the one that best maps your market. But today, I'll build a custom view so we can see who sells what and how much they earn. I select any cell, go to Insert, Pivot Table, select From Table, Range, choose New Worksheet, and press OK. Now I decide which stalls in the market I want to see. I drag Salesperson into the rows area. These are our historical traders. Under that, I drag Product, so each seller's goods are listed beneath their name. Next, I add Units Sold to the Values area, then Revenue as well. Now, I can instantly see what each merchant sold and how much gold they earned. You'll notice signature strengths bubble up. Cleopatra with perfume, Genghis Khan with war horses, and so on. Our pivot table is built, so let's make it presentable for our royal guests. Clicking inside the table brings up the Pivot Table Design tab. I'll select banded rows in a light green. The bold headers, subtotals, and grand totals are included by default. This is clean and easy to read. The style will automatically adapt if I change the layout, like a market tent that reshapes itself when you move the stalls. In the grand competition of history's best salespeople, we need a quick way to see who's leading. First, to avoid totals dwarfing everything, I go to Design, Subtotals, Do Not Show Subtotals, and Grand Totals, off for rows and columns. Then I highlight the entire revenue column in the pivot table, not just one cell, and go to Home, Conditional Formatting, Data Bars, Solid Fill. Excel fills each value cell with a bar. The longer the bar, the greater the revenue. So from across the market, you can instantly spot Joan of Arc's booming medieval armor replica trade, or Genghis Khan's thriving horse business without reading a single number. Let's add some flavor to the numbers so they match the spirit of our marketplace. I right-click a revenue value, choose number format, and switch to custom. In the format box, I can select any format, so I select the #.#0 format. But then I put my chosen words in double quotes. For example, to show amounts as gold coins, I type number format, space, double quotes, the words gold coins, double quotes. Those quotation marks tell Excel to display the words exactly as I type them. I can just as easily swap gold coins for scrolls, crowns, or denarii. The math doesn't change, but now every sale in the table feels like part of our historical bazaar. Now read the table with those bars and gold coins applied. Cleopatra dominates Pharaoh's perfume. Genghis Khan spikes on war horses. The revenue bars tower. Joan of Arc shines on medieval armor replicas. Leonardo da Vinci leads with curious gadgets. They all sell all four products, but those signature lines clearly surge. Exactly how our dataset was designed. Sometimes you don't want one big report. You want separate pages for each merchant. Here's how. Drag Salesperson into the Filters area of the pivot table. Then go to Pivot Table Analyze. Options. Show Report Filter Pages. A small window appears. I choose Salesperson and click OK. Like magic, Excel creates four brand new sheets, each pre-filtered for one merchant: Genghis Khan, Joan of Arc, Cleopatra, and Leonardo da Vinci. Every sheet keeps the same style and currency formatting as the main table, but now shows only that merchant's sales. It's perfect for sending personal results to each merchant. No editing, no filtering, just ready to print report. Let's give our report some fresh stock. I just copy the whole table and add it to the bottom of our original table. This is exactly why we converted our dataset into a table at the start. The pivot table is already connected to it, so we don't have to change the data source manually. Once the new rows are in, I simply right-click anywhere in the pivot table and then refresh. Excel instantly pulls in the new data, reapplies all my formatting, and updates those signature spikes. And here's the best part. Those individual merchant reports we created earlier, they update automatically as soon as the main pivot table refreshes. No extra clicks, no separate edits. Everything stays perfectly in sync. In just 5 minutes, we've turned a sprawling historical sales log into a clean, interactive dashboard. With a custom layout, clear styling, dynamic formatting, themed currency, and personal ledgers. And with just one click to refresh, this market will stay open for business all year long. Thanks for watching and happy excelling.